today I'm going to a place to railfan that I haven't been to since 2017. Well, excluding the one time I went there to see Amtrak last year. But where is that, you might ask? Durand.
Durand, Michigan is your average American small town, apart from it being a railfan hotspot in the state. At its peak in the early 1900s, Durand saw over 100 trains a day, and Union Station hosted 3,000 passengers daily from the Grand Trunk Western and Ann Arbor Railroads. Times have greatly changed since then, though, with cars, trucks, and planes taking precedence over trains since the 1960s. Thankfully, the railroad spirit lives on in Durand with outdoor displays, and the magnificent Union Station being preserved as an Amtrak station and host of the Michigan Railroad Museum and private events. As of 2024, you'll see around 20 freight trains a day thanks to Canadian National, Great Lakes Central, and Huron and Eastern. Amtrak's Blue Water Service also stops in Durand on its daily round trip between Port Huron and Chicago. The station is a great bird-watching and railfanning spot with a diamond in view and an ATCS board to keep track of what's coming. The first train I saw came drifting around the Chicago Y from the Holly Subdivision onto the Flint line, but it showed up just as I arrived, so I wasn't exactly prepared for it, and the second train going the opposite direction also snuck up on me when I wasn't paying attention, so the camera work is kind of crappy, but it'll get better after those two. A while later, a former City Rail Jivo takes the lead on an eastbound auto rack train slamming the one-way low-speed diamond. I remember back in 2018 when CN was going through a power shortage, it seemed like there were leaser units like these on every other train.
Oh, now I hear it. There he is.
The afternoon sun was really starting to heat things up as yet another eastbound auto rack train cruises by the station. For my last train of the day, I moved to the Byron Road crossing on the Holly sub. This spot is outside the quiet zone imposed back in town. Coming from the Flint sub, an early era Gevo, SD70M-2, and an Illinois Central GP38-2 lead a mixed freight southeast towards Pontiac. Jumping ahead to August, I once again visited Durand, but I forgot CN was just getting out of a lockout, so there weren't as many trains running. Regardless, my first catch was a westbound CN freight coming off the Holly sub onto the Flint line. The SD75i trailing was starting to show its age. Thank you. Next up is a northbound Great Lakes Central train. GLC makes brief use of trackage rights over CN's Holly sub here to access the Huron and Eastern yard up ahead. They then travel on the Huron and Eastern's Owosso branch until GLC returns to home rails in Owosso. A pair of former Montana Rail Link SD35s were the power today. My final catch would be a CN freight making a lot of screeching noise on the high Y going onto the Holly sub. I wouldn't want to live in any of the houses nearby listening to this every day. thank you to my channel members. Special thanks to Mooter, Tommy Rosini, Grand Canyon Studios, Amtrak Fan 19, Gojira's Trains, Aaron Forestry YT, Axel Proto, the Winnipeg Railfan, Michigan Central Railfan, Jack O'Beans, Puncake, and Jackboy317 for subscribing to the Conductor tier. Your extra support helps make trips like these possible. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video.